We've been investigating the impact of prescription drug overdoses in America for some time on this program. As you may know, someone dies every 19 minutes in this country because of such an overdose. And today I want to talk about a medicine that some people say could help stop this epidemic, but only if we get it in the hands of more people, not just doctors, but average people as well. Now look, it's controversial, but you're about to see this incredible video showing how it might work. What you're looking at is pretty shocking. A heroin addict overdosing. Her name is Liz. She's been using drugs since she was 11. Today, she's 29. Adam Wigglesworth and Louise Vincent were both with her that night in August. They both volunteer with a program in Greensboro, North Carolina, that provides clean needles and other assistance to addicts.
She seemed to be pretty unresponsive, and we were noticing a bluing of the lips, lack of oxygen, so her breathing had become quite shallow.
Well, once someone's not breathing and they're not responding to any sort of stimulus, you give them breath, and at that time, I usually administer Naloxone.
Now watch what happens next.
We gave her about 60 units of Narcan.
Narcan, also known as Naloxone, can reverse an overdose from heroin and other drugs, like oxycodone. Another sternal rub, another shot of Narcan.
All right, let's go ahead and give her some more Narcan.
Giving her the rest of this full CC.
And finally, Liz begins to come too.
We've given you some Narcan. Liz, you overdosed. Can you sit up? All right, come on.
When someone takes heroin, the drug locks onto receptors in the brain. It slows the body down. Lock up too many, and you stop breathing. Naloxone can free up those receptors, essentially bringing you back to life. You might wonder, that video of Liz, is that real? Well, we showed it to four emergency room doctors who all said, yes, this is what a recovery with Narcan looks like.
I can't believe that somebody cared about me enough or, you know, loved me enough to bring me back.
Back to right a life that somehow went wrong. We met Liz on the day she checked into rehab, packing up her things, taking another look at the album of her 19-month-old daughter.
You know, I had felt so separated and just like disassociated from my daughter because I felt like, you know, basically like I wasn't good enough to take care of her. I can't finish school, I can't hold down a job, I can't, you know, do any of this like normal stuff that everyday people have absolutely no problem. Like, it's not a challenge for them.
Naloxone gave Liz a second chance. It also gave Linda Woline a second chance. She remembers the day she found her son Steve face down in the front yard.
My husband ran out and started rescue breathing, and I ran in and got the Narcan.
It's right here.
He was laying on his back, totally blue. So the Narcan, as soon as it got into his nostrils, he started to stir and wake up, and came to. Thank God for Narcan.
Narcan, or Naloxone, is distributed as part of Massachusetts' Opioid Overdose Pilot Prevention Program, and Dr. Alexander Wally is the medical director.
Initially, this program was targeted towards high-risk injection drug users. We soon started to hear about parents going to needle exchanges.
Today, the program distributes Naloxone to addicts, first responders, and Learn to Cope. That's a support group for parents of addicts. Linda has been going to Learn to Cope meetings for the past 9 years.
Nasal Naloxone Narcan, the overdose reversal antidote, is available weekly at all LTC meetings. If you're in this room, you should have Narcan.
Learn to Cope has distributed hundreds of Naloxone kits to its members, who have managed to reverse at least 9 overdoses.
Tinging of the lips,
fingernails, bluish, anything like that also,
okay.
If you can't arouse them.
It's ready to administer,
okay.
And it'll go up one nostril, half.
It's one of those things that, you know, you can't believe that you're signing up for this, but the reality is if you have an addict, you should have Narcan.
In the United States, overdoses kill more people than car accidents. And since 1990, prescription drug overdoses have more than tripled.
I think it makes a lot of sense to, for example, co-prescribe naloxone with chronic pain medication. So people will have it in their home, in their medicine cabinet, and instruct their family members how to use it. So if somebody is overdosing, then they can administer it to them while they wait for help to arrive, just as you would for an EpiPen.
But Dr. Ed Boyer also warns it won't always work.
It requires people understand that the medications, you know, last longer. The medications may be more potent than individuals anticipate. The absolute need to call 911 has to be made clear.
As a parent, Lyndon knows what it's like to want to save your child.
You must have Narcan if you have an addict. You must. Absolutely. Because the whole trick of it is to keep them alive until they finally get it.
Now, you might have noticed that none of the people called 911. And I'll tell you that I think that's a terrible oversight. If you do see that someone's unconscious, you need to immediately call for help before you jump in. Keep that in mind. In any case, some doctors think naloxone might give addicts and their friends and their family a false sense of security as well. Could be a lifesaver, but these are clearly some pretty tough issues.